This is the Friday afternoon QSOVILAC Network. And now let's check in and see if Charlie, K1GZL, is on frequency to bring us up to date on the latest 40-meter band propagation. Charlie's QTH is up north in northern New Hampshire, near the Canadian border. Charlie, got a copy?
Yes, Jim, there is Queen Sugar Baker, but you're peaking up to about S8, almost a 9, direct at the present time. So, if you're copying me, I've got something interesting on here on 20 meters at 20 minutes to 1 in the morning, K1GZL.
Yes, sir, Charlie, I've got you about 15 over on Milford, PASDR. Go ahead, sir.
About 15 over on Milford, PASDR. Go ahead, sir.
Okay, I was decided to see what was on 20 as we got closer to midnight last night, and son of a gun, I heard some ZLs and VKs coming in on short path on 20, and I did get a hold of VK4 Kilowatt Alpha, VK4KA, that is Corey, C-O-R-Y, and he's 25 miles north of Brisbane. B-R-I-S-B-A-N-E, I think it is, 25 miles north of Brisbane. Here he is. I hope.
Definitely see you later on. K1GZL from KX4 Whiskey Charlie, we are clear.
Okay, here we go.
This is 300 off of K1GZL, C-4KA,
Okay, and that was short path. That was short path down north of Brisbane. Brisbane would be somewhere probably about 10, 15 degrees north of my main signal on 20, but it would be way off my antenna on 40 meters. By the way, I went through an interesting experience. I was hospitalized a few days ago. Every 4 or 5 weeks, Jim, every 4 or 5 weeks, I get a day or so where my heart rate goes crazy and fibrillation and the whole nine yards. But when I've been seeing doctors, it hasn't happened, but this time it did. So they took a look and said, well, we're going to put you in the Littleton, that's Littleton, New Hampshire Hospital. That's about 6970 road miles to my southwest. And I stayed overnight, and they had me on tubes and EKGs and the whole nine yards. And it was just endless. And I only got a half an hour sleep. Because I had to lie in the exact spot, or else it would everything would cut off. So that was horrible. But what it is, this is K1GZL, not causing the problem I had, but they did find my heart was in excellent condition, and the rest of my body okay, fine. However, the valves, the aorta valve and the other valves going into my heart, had narrowed down, not to the point to cause any problems right now, but had narrowed down. So eventually I was going to have that corrected. I said, would I have to have open heart surgery? And they said, no, you don't. We put this, put it up the arm. It's a 2-hour procedure. And you're in la-la-la-la land, but you are still somewhat conscious, and that should take care of the problem. So what an experience, KC9, VKV, K1GZL.
Roger, Charlie. Now, was this like a pacemaker or what?
Roger, Charlie.
Oh, no. No pacemakers, no. what they would have to do is put up more of those valves or whatever, right where it enters the heart, because where the arteries are coming into the heart, it builds up a circular of. That stuff, you know, that I just mentioned, but I forgot the name, that has to be removed. So they said you probably have another year, a year. In that case, you'll start getting chest pains and shortness of breath. So I've got to eventually see a cardiologist and discuss this with a cardiologist. I would rather get it done sooner because you never know with this thing. But no pacemaker. Oh, no. Jim. K1GZL.
Roger, Roger. Charlie, well, I wish you all the luck in the world there to resolve the issue. I know that heart rates fluctuating, heart rates can be disturbing. So I'm glad that they have figured out what it is, and hopefully it won't cause you too much problems until they decide to correct it. Roger, Roger.
Problems until they decide to correct it. Roger, Roger.
Yeah, Roger, Roger. I don't know if I just mentioned it or not. I thought it would be possibly open heart surgery, and they said, "Oh no, 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 no. We'll put us up through your arm." Through your arm. I think I just said that, but maybe I didn't. By the way, Jim, you've got a beautiful signal now. You're up to a 9 and on direct path. Here it is.
I've figured out what it is, and hopefully it won't cause you too much problems until they decide to correct it. Roger, Roger.
Okay, Roger, Roger is right. Well, look, I'll let you go, Jim. I'll let you go, and it's a pleasure always working you. Our warmest day so far this season, we're just touching 84 degrees, 84 in the shade, and the normal high is 61 degrees is the normal high, so that is in the extreme. We had a quarter of an inch of rain and a shower, a thunderstorm yesterday afternoon. That was interesting. So I'll say the very best, Jim. Thank you very much for picking me up again, and I'll keep you updated to what may be coming. We might say down the pike, KZ9VKV. There goes my voice, K1GZL.
Roger, Roger, Charlie 73 up that way, sir, and enjoy that sunshine and beautiful Florida weather while it lasts. Oh, you're pretty lucky. And we had a pretty warm day here today. I've been trying to ride my bike again. I did quite a bit of bike riding, 5-6 years ago, and then last few years, two or so, I gave it up, and my doctor suggested that I might, if I valued my life, might want to take up bike riding again. So I have, and it's interesting. Today was a fairly warm day, and we have a nice little park in the area that has a pedway, and this pedway is just over a mile long. And so as you ride around, you sometimes are facing the sun, sometimes you have your back to it. But I was trying to keep sun under control as far as, what it's doing to the skin, So I had some SPF 30 or whatever it is on my arms. I had a long sleeve shirt, so it worked out all right, but I hope it cools down here in the next couple of days, because I enjoy that. Anyway, this is KC9VKV. My name is Jim. Some know me better as Dr. VKV. And we're recording now live till 5, so if you have a radio you want to check out, give us a shout. We'll post this recording up on YouTube in the next couple of days. So when you go to YouTube, just do a call and a search for KC9VKV, along with today's date, 5/21/21, and that will take you directly to this recording, where, it'll be about an hour and a half long. We record now live till 5, And then if you might be interested in just checking some of our Kiss of Elok recordings, we now have over 1,600, and you can access those by going to YouTube and just doing a call letter search, KC9VKV by itself, and that will take you to our Kiss of Elok page, where, like I say, we have about 1,650 recorded Kiss of Eloks. So with that, let's open her up to see if anybody wants to check in. This is KC9VKV. If you have a radio you want to check out, give me a shout.